Today I'm in Tiverton at XYZ Machine Tools. I've come here to see their first ever turning centre with a subspindle. Mark, some may say it's been a long time coming for XYZ because this is a machine that I imagine your customers are really after, isn't it?
Yes, we've had lots of inquiries for subspindle lathes over the years, many customers chasing it, and glad we finally decided to get one in.
Why do they want it? What's the reason?
It's so you can do the full job in one hit. You know, you can put the bar in, set the job running, and when it's finished, the whole entire workpiece, front end and back end, is complete.
But it's also about the reliability of the part being made, isn't it? How does that differ with a subspindle?
Well, because it's all done in one hit on the same machine, everything's perfectly in line. Whereas if you take it from one machine to another, you've then got to clock everything up and make sure everything's perfectly aligned.
And your control here, this is one of the things we talk to your customers in the field about. They really do love and are really getting to grips now with these touchscreen solutions, aren't they? If you were new to a one-hit machining environment, how easy is it to program?
Well, it's the Siemens 828D conversational shop turn control, which lots of our customers are used to on the turning centres, either standard or the LTYs. The control's identical, absolutely identical. Programming is exactly the same, the only difference being the small cycle to transfer from one spindle to the other. It even mirrors the axis, so you're still programming the cutting in the same direction.
Is there anything you have to think differently about with a subspindle machine? Because this is your first subspindle here as well, Mark. Have you had to change your engineering mindset when you look at how you're going to create your part?
Yeah, quite a lot, in the fact that the tools are arranged around the periphery instead of the face on our usual VDI turret machines. This is a VDI 30 turret machine, but everything's around the periphery, so you've really got to be careful of your distances on your tools from each other, and you know the distances to the chuck jaws, etc.
But would you also look at it like when you're making a part and think, actually, I can make this a little bit differently now because I can do it in one hit?
Yeah, certainly. Yeah, you can program it however you like now. So you can do smaller amounts on the front end, transfer it over, do whatever's needed on the back end of the part.
And now let's talk about the machine itself then, Mark. We've got what I can only describe as a much bigger window on this than a lot of machines. That will give comfort to some operators so they can actually see what's happening inside the working area.
Yeah, you've got a great viewing area through that window on all the machining aspects.
And what does a machine come with?
Yeah, so on the standard spindle, you've got a 200mm 3-jaw chuck. On the subspindle, you've got a 150mm 3-jaw chuck. You've got a 65mm bore on the main spindle, 52mm bore on the subspindle, and you've got an automatic tool setting arm for each spindle.
And what will the Y-axis give to users that don't know what that can actually provide in a machining environment?
Well, we've got 100mm on the Y-axis, 50mm plus or minus. So whereas an old-style turning centre with live tooling used the C-axis to produce flats or pockets and you know various milling operations, we can actually mill flats now. We can make flat pockets in the side of a component or anything with a large flat on there.
Okay, and taking into account all of the points we've spoken about, the automation, the second spindle, the Y-axis and driven tools, for XYZ, is this going to open up many more opportunities other than your customer base?
Yes, definitely, because we've had quite a few customers who've inquired about a subspindle lathe with us because they like our existing XYZ machine tools, but we've not been able to offer that in the past, so they have actually looked at other suppliers.
Because you can now really service production demands, can't you? Companies where they're chasing cycle times, they need to keep the machine running. This is an area that before and without a subspindle may have been hard for you to penetrate.
Yeah, that's right, yeah, definitely.
And if you were to be a company that, you know, this is their first venture into, one-hit machining, it'll be important for them to know and hear from you what they can expect from a support and a training element.
They'll get exactly the same support and training package that we give on all our machines.
And the very fact that these machines are here, people can come and see them. They can see them cutting like we have today. But they'll need to be quite quick, I would imagine, because I can't imagine either of this pair being here for too long.
No, that's right. We've already got demos lined up for not in the too distant future.